Depression is super challenging in autism. When we ask ourselves, why didn't anyone do the trial? It's because even making the diagnosis and measuring severity is very, very difficult. I came into this field kind of naive, thinking like, oh, well, you know, if the person has normal language and their IQ is in the normal range, like, they'll be able to tell me if they're depressed, right? No, absolutely not. Remember, it's a core symptom of autism to have difficulty identifying and expressing their emotions. Then I was like, okay, their self-report is not easy to follow. I'll use my mental status exam. That didn't work either, because people with autism have real differences in their baseline affect. So it can be more constricted, the prosody of their speech can be a little bit odd or kind of monotone. So that's actually not very helpful either. So what do I do? I use a lot more collateral report than I would normally for an equivalent patient of the same age and cognitive ability. And many of my patients really welcome that because they have that insight that I'm not good at doing this, ask my mom. And it doesn't mean to say that we shouldn't, you know, help patients develop the language and ability to be aware of and express their emotions, but it's really, really helpful to ask their mom. You can also kind of hang your hat a little bit more on some of the neurovegetative symptoms. So things are more objective, changes in sleep, energy, appetite. Depression can frequently, in my clinical experience, present as irritability in people with autism, kind of in more of that childlike presentation of depression. But I'll be humble, it's really, really tricky. And I wanted to illustrate that using a case example where the diagnosis can feel not really slam dunk, and the outcome when you treat it also doesn't feel like, oh, I really got that. So this was a young lady who was about 21 when I met her. She has autism, obviously, because that's what I do. I said, how are you feeling? She was like, meh, stressed. All right. Are you depressed? No, no, no. Kind of questioned her a little bit more, and then she kind of fessed up to having a lot of thoughts about feeling like that a lot of things are her fault, and that she was always messing up. You know, her mom was there, fortunately, and was able to say, like, yeah, you know, she's never been a half glass full type of girl, but she seems more down. So I said, okay, let's increase your fluoxetine. She came back a little bit later. Immediately the patient was like, I don't know if the med's working, I'm terrible at doing this, just ask my mom. And her mom said, you know, I think the med's working. She's a little bit more interested in doing things. She's more agreeable when things don't go her way. And guess what? She actually participated in her IEP meeting for the first time in 21 years. I said, all right, I'll take it. So that's kind of what depression can look like and feel like when you're treating it in this patient population.